Okay, good morning, Miranda. Myself, T. Parmesh, Associate Professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering. So, today the topic is friction. So, in the friction is when the two bodies are in contact, there is a limited amount of resistance will be developed. So, this resistance is called frictional force one. Suppose when the body is resting on a horizontal plane, when we are applying the external force, suppose capital P, the body will be moving total towards left side, right side. The frictional force, it will be acting left side on. Next, weight of the body. The always it will be considered the center of the block. We have to consider weight downwards and R will be considered perpendicular to the plane. These three we have to consider. So here particular in this block, only the block is moving total towards right side. Some external force, suppose 40 newtons. That will be always, it will be in opposite direction of the motion only, frictional force. So here F is equal to mu into R, means mu is equal to F by R, frictional coefficient of frictional, mu is equal to F by R. So here in this one, when you have to consider in the sigma x equation, the sigma x only in x direction of the forces. So here this should be considered the x direction, right side plus left side minus. In the y direction, we have to consider upward plus downwards minus. So when you have to consider, when you have to write down the sigma x equation, only the x direction of the forces only we have to consider. So sigma x, so this is right side, the parallel to the plane of the object. So here capital P, positive. Next, in only in x direction, this is the direction of left side, so minus F. So P minus F equal to 0. When you have to consider in sigma y only in y direction, this direction should be considered upward. So upward means plus R. Here downwards minus W equal to 0. So in this one, so here only the x direction of the forces and y direction of the forces only. Suppose when you have to consider the block, the block is moving, suppose making an angle of theta, suppose if it is moving, see this condition of the object. Suppose external force, capital P, making an angle of theta. So here, in this one also the block is moving total towards right side only. So here in this case, again we have to consider same thing. The frictional force, will be left side. Next, weight downwards and R will be perpendicular to this plane, 90 degrees. So in this case, so here previous one, first one is only the external force is parallel to the plane of the object only. So this block is moving total towards right side. So in this one, the external force making an angle of theta. When you have to observe, this block also moving total towards right side only. So same thing, but before that, when you have to write down the equation, sigma x and sigma y, we have to resolve with external force. So how to resolve the external force means, so here tail goes to head direction. Tail goes to head direction. We are dissolving. Why? Because we have to write down the sigma x equation and sigma y equation. So here when you have write down these two equations, before that we have to resolve of this capital P. If it is parallel means, the first case no need to resolve. But in this one capital P making an angle of theta. So here we have to compulsory we have to resolve. So with x and y. So how to resolve this capital P making an angle of theta means, the tail goes to in head direction only. So here we are dissolving with x axis. So tail goes to head. This is the starting point, this is the ending point. So we are dissolving with x axis and y axis only. So we are dissolving with x and y. So tail goes to head direction, moving with x and upper direction again. So finally we are dissolving with x axis and y axis. So without dissolving these two, we can't write down the equation, sigma x and sigma y. So compulsory we have resolved. Previous one is only the total external force is parallel to the plane. Here no need to resolve. This plus P, right side, minus F, left side, equal to 0.
But here making an angular theta, so compulsory we have to resolve. So in this one, tail goes straight direction means right side, again upwards. After that, here theta, the opposite to the plane, it will get sine on. So write down P sine theta. Here we have write down what below P cos theta on. So after that, we have to write down the equation sigma x and sigma y. In the sigma x, when you write down the equation, see that the only x direction of the force is only we are writing sigma x equal to 0 and sigma y equal to 0. So these x direction of the forces, this p cos theta will be x axis and p sin theta y axis. Again, no need to consider this p, already we are resolving. After resolving only we will get sigma x and y direction. So finally in that, see that this is x axis and this one y axis, here y axis, x axis. So first we have write down the only in the sigma x direction of the forces only we have to write down. So when you write down the sigma x equal to 0, see that p cos theta, this is right side. Right side means plus p cos theta. Next, this is left side. Left side means minus. Minus f equal to 0. Only in x direction of the forces on. So plus p cos theta minus f equal to 0. Next, when you write down the sigma y equation. In the sigma y equation, we have considered only in the y direction of the forces. This should be considered upwards. So here p sin theta. P sin theta, next y direction, plus or upwards, plus or, next downwards, only in y direction, minus, minus w equal to 0. So here these total, this P means external forces, F will be, we have to consider frictional forces. Here F is equal to mu into R, mu is equal to F by R on. Coefficient of friction, mu means. So after that, we have to find out the values in the problem it is given, whatever that. So this is the total entire, the procedure for the, if the block is moving total, this one is, block is moving total towards right side, here also right side only, but making an angle of theta. So in this case, here only two cases. Next one is, we have to consider if the block is resting on the inclined plane, suppose making an angle of theta. So in this case, suppose if the block here resting, first case is resting on horizontal plane and the second one is making an angle of theta, block also moving with horizon. Here the block is resting on inclined plane. Suppose if it is external force parallel to the plane on, suppose here external force parallel to the plane, if it is moving this block, if it is moving total upward direction, here external force either. Suppose without external force, this block is moving downwards on. Here we are applying the external force, capital P. So these symbols either, direction is important. Suppose I didn't mention anything for the capital P, suppose direction. So this block is moving total towards downwards on. So here direction is either, first we have to observe the direction. So here clearly is given, the direction is parallel to the plane, the block is moving total towards upper direction. The upper direction means we have to consider the total frictional force. Frictional force, we have to consider the total entire moving downwards on. So here entire, the parallel to the plane on. Next we have to consider the weight of the object and reactional force. It will mean perpendicular to the plane passing through the total entire the weight of center of the object only. So these are the cases only. For this, the block is moving total towards right side or left side, resting on an inclined plane. Okay, these are the conditions. Okay, so next class we will discuss remaining the objects.